And have we got a show for you today? And welcome to Charlando con la Comunidad. This is Abelardo Hernandez speaking to you. And I want to thank Bill and Cheryl for the help in this program. And tonight we have, as you see, I have my veteran shirt on and my cap from the Mexican American club, Veterans Club, so, because we're going to be talking about mainly a lot about the World War II veterans and the effect that the Mexican Americans had in the Second World War. Of course, they all participated in the Korean War, in the Vietnam War, in the war in Iraq, but I think the biggest thing was in the Second World War, and as you might know, there was 750,000 Chicanos or Mexican Americans, you might want to say, that went to war in the Second World War, and they won more medals of honor than any other ethnic group in the United States. And as a matter of fact, last week down in El Paso, they honored some veterans from the Second World War from the Company E of the 36th Division. They gave them their high school diplomas because a lot of them had quit school before they graduated. A lot of them got drafted before they graduated. So they were honored with their high school diplomas. And as a matter of fact, one of them was Andres Saucedo, Alex Rivas, and Richard Palacios. They were present for their diplomas, but there were three others also who received the diplomas posthumously, but there were quite a few also very famous, known for their company. Company E was an all Chicano company. There was mostly all Mexican Americans in their company, and there was a captain Navarrete that I might want to mention him because there's a big story about that Company E where his commander, General Mark Clark, I guess they sent him out to cross this one river called the Rio Rapido, and a lot of his men were massacred, so he wanted to go out there and shoot the commander, and I guess there was a big scandal about it, but anyway, they went ahead and they never did do anything to him. I guess they thought he was going to have to go before the court martial, but he didn't. But anyway, he was involved also after the second invasion of the 36th, landing southern France at Toulon. They went from Oberhofen and they smashed across the Rhine River into Germany at Wissenburg, where they planted a Lone Star flag of Texas. And then from there, and he was involved in capturing the number one general, Field Marshal von Rundstedt. Excuse me. and he was the leader of the largest army offensive. And also Reichmeister Hermann Goering. He was the biggest Nazi of all. So Captain Gabriel Navarrete, he won a service cross, a bronze star, two silver stars He did not get the Medal of Honor, though. But there was also another man who got a lot of medals was Charles Victor Porras there from El Paso, and he got the Navy Cross. He was also involved in a lot of the battles. He did a lot of things all by himself. But there was also a Medal of Honor winner who was done posthumously. Uh, he received it posthumously in Korea, Benito Martinez, and in Korea also was Edward Gomez, and Miguel Hernandez Keith. He was a Medal of Honor winner for Vietnam. But like I said, there were so many of these people who were involved and fought with valor in the Second World War. Tonight also, I'm probably going to show you a little video of some of the veterans that we here in Omaha honored, and Mr. Ricardo Arellano, who is the president of our Mexican American Veterans Club, he's the one who he did the presentation. We presented him with some plaques, and there were actually seven of them, but only six of them were present. But one of them was Lano Arellano from the who was in the Army. Tony Martinez. Tony Martinez was actually in the Battle of the Bulge. He didn't really brag about it too much, but that's what happened. And anyway, there was Leonard Arenas and John Gomez. He was also in the Army. And in the Navy, there was Joe Juarez and Paul Marquez. And there was another one who, like I say, was not present, was Ernie Plaza. But all these people will probably be in that video when we do the presentation. But I was looking up some of these World War II veterans, and a lot of them turned out to be good writers, and a lot of them wrote stories about the war, and a lot of them, and also about the discrimination, because like this guy Andres Saucedo, he says that when they came from the war, they were down in the northern part of Texas, in I think it was Lubbock, and they were in their uniform, and the war had just ended, and the United States won the war and whatever, and yet they wouldn't even let them stay in a motel there. So that it goes to show you that the discrimination had not ended. You know, it was still the same. It's the same thing that happened to this baseball club that went to Austin, Texas to play in the state championship. These young Mexican kids from Bowie High School in El Paso, and they couldn't even stay in motels either, in any kind of hotel, and they couldn't even eat at the restaurants. And that goes to show you that even though these people played a big part in the war, they were still not allowed to stay in a lot of these places. These writers, I might say, from World War II, there was quite a few writers also that came from the Korean War and also from the Vietnam War. But I would like to mention some of these from the Second World War. It was Luis Leal and S.D. Navarro, Felipe de Ortego, Sabine Ulibarri, Américo Paredes. Américo Paredes, I've read some stories that he wrote. He was a very famous. Octavio Romano, and Cesar Chavez too. He was in the Navy. He became a pretty famous American, and with the farm, he was involved with the farm workers. So he also, wrote some articles and some stories. And there was also a judge who wrote a lot of articles. His name was Albert Armendariz. And then also there's a very famous a muralist there in El Paso who was, his name was Ernesto Pedregón. And a very good friend of mine, he happened to be my next door neighbor. He was a tail gunner in the Army Air Force, and he also was a famous artist. He used to teach me how to draw and how to proportion the drawings and things. And he became a very famous painter there in El Paso. And his name was Manuel Gregorio Acosta, And he's still very famous there in El Paso. And he used to also do murals once in a while, but he'd do them out of town. But for now, I will go ahead and we'll take a pause and we'll show the names. There's a little short video and very interesting because it has music to it. And it's called El Soldado Raso. And it has a name of, it'll show you the names of these World War II veterans that received plaques from our Mexican-American club that we have here in Omaha. And we have had very much success in trying to help some of these very well-deserved veterans because they serve their country very well. Now, these men are actually from Omaha. They're not from any other place. We have a lot of them from Nebraska, too. But we'll go ahead and finish right now, and we'll talk to you in a little while.
God, we support you, and we know you will be victorious. May God bless you all, and may God bless America.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're back, and I think our last part of portion of the program is going to be more or less a departure from our program right here, right now, and we'll just say our goodbyes because we're going to be showing the actual presentation of these plaques that Mr. Rick Arellano, I was trying to get him to come on the show, but I didn't notify him soon enough, and I'm sorry for that, but I would have liked for him to be here with me, and we might have been able to discuss some of the things a little bit better, but he has been very instrumental in procuring a lot of things for a lot of our veterans. I think last year too, he presented a plaque to another veteran who was from Bellevue, Nebraska, and also the reason we wanted to do this is because we're starting to lose a lot of our World War II veterans, and we didn't get a chance to really honor them as well as we wanted to. We'll go ahead and show the video today, and then we can end the show in that way and I want to thank Reynaldo Cervantes too for editing this video that I did, because I'm still not very good at doing some of this video, and he was able to edit it for me and cut it down and shorten it up a little bit, that way it could be a better quality. But little by little, I'm hoping to do a few more of these little videos where I can actually do a lot of it myself without having to impose on somebody else to do these editing for me. But little by little, I'm kind of learning how to do a lot of these things. So I'm gonna go ahead and have at the end of the show we'll have Rick Arellano do this real nice video. I think Reynaldo did a real good job on this video, because I want these recipients of these plaques to also be able to watch it, and I hope that they like it, because I wouldn't want to disappoint them, because I promised them that I was going to put them on TV, on public TV, so I guess they pretty much like to see themselves too, you know. They want to see how people might respect them a little bit more after they see him, you know, on the screen, I suppose. But I was hoping that they would have said a few more words when they received their plaque. A lot of them were a little bit shy, I guess, even though they didn't know they were being videotaped. They were kind of brief in their reception of their awards. But I was hoping that they would have at least, you know, got to say a little few more things. Even though Leonardo Hernandez, and I want to thank Reynaldo Cervantes and Bill and Cheryl for helping me with this whole show, because I'm really excited about this whole show, because it's really, really, it has a lot of impact on what we were doing. And I want to thank you, and I bid you good night, and I thank you.
We got a presentation for these individuals that put on a uniform in the defense of this country. When they were needed, they never held back. They were right there in the time of war. This one individual put on a Navy uniform and served on a ship during the war. His name is Paul Marcus.
All right, Paul Marcus!
From the Mexican-American veterans, gratefully recognize Mr. Paul Marcus for his military service to the United States of America. Would you like to say something, Paul?
Thank you, and I'm lucky because I come back.
All right, Paul!
This individual is another person that put his uniform on and went to serve his country when the call came. His name is Lano Oropesa. The plaque reads, the Mexican-American veterans honor Lano Oropesa for his military service and dedication to the United States of America.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you to the Mexican-Americans here present today. Thank you very much.
The next individual is Mr. Leonard Arenas. The plaque reads, this plaque is presented to Leonard Arenas by the Mexican-American veterans for the military service and dedication to the United States of America from the Mexican-American veterans.
My father, Leonard Arenas, he thanks the Mexican-American for giving him this honor. Thank you.
Leonard was also another person that continued after his service to serve for the community. I know he was a member of the Mexican-American Veterans. He was also a member of the Honor Guard for the American GI Forum. The next person to be honored today is Mr. Tony Martinez. But from what I've heard, that he was in a very famous battle.
Rick,
can called the Battle of the Bulge. So it is a privilege to give these people this recognition they deserve. The plaque reads, for the Mexican-American veterans, we recognize Tony Martinez for his dedication and military service to the United States of America.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I deserve it.
No wonder he came back. The next veteran to be honored is Mr. John Gomez.
All right, John!
From the stories I've heard about Mr. Gomez, he was in places that a lot of people didn't want to go. This is the kind of person that makes our country what we are today. All these veterans have given us the freedom that we have today. So Mr. John Gomez, I am very proud to represent you with this plaque. And the plaque reads, the Mexican-American veterans present to Mr. John Gomez. This plaque for his dedication and military service to the United States of America. Mr. Gomez.
Thank you very much. I'm proud to serve the Army. I was a General Patton, 3rd Army. I was a machine gunner. And before, I like to say this, if I can, I married my wife before I went to the service. We've been married 71 years so far.
We serve gallantly and bravely for this country. So the Mexican-American veterans are proud to present this flag, this plaque, to Mr. Joe Juarez. The plaque reads, to Mexican-American veterans, we salute Joe Juarez for his dedication and service to the United States of America and military service. Mr. Juarez.
We got one more presentation to give away.